Victory is supported by Skyline Drive Corvette Club and Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.
Hi, good evening to another exciting program, Victory, here on BCTV, your channel to your community. Hi, I'm Tom Frank, your Victory host tonight. 16 years we've been broadcasting out the Victory Show here at BCTV. 183 shows, and this is the first show, I have to admit, is the largest format of people, the fastest producing one. We've been able to put this show on in about 3 days because this is a great mission call. It is truly Team 127. It's the Haiti Relief, and it's from the United Methodist Church in West Lawn. We have most of the team members here with us with their leadership, and this is a cause that we are all trying to reach out to you, the home viewer of Berks County. So let's, with no further ado, let's move through the panel of who we have with us tonight as guests. This is a live broadcast. We encourage your call-ins, your questions that you might have about what's going on with Haiti, how this team is helping to raise funds to really help rebuild some of the schools down there that they have already been working on in years past. As a reminder, if you want to call into the studio, the number is 610-378-0426. Let's meet our first panel of guests with the team leadership at West Lawn United Methodist Church.
Thanks, Tom. I'm Jeannie Hetrick, and this is my husband, Billy. We are the youth ministers at West Lawn United Methodist Church.
I'm Mark Gillette. I'm involved with the leadership of Team 127, a nonprofit organization who is the broker of the resources of the United States with the great faith that we see demonstrated in Haiti.
Okay, Joe, welcome.
And I'm Joe Keel, and I'm the youth leader with the West Lawn United Methodist Church. And I'm helping out with the Team 127 for the Haiti Fund.
That's great. Joe's going to be showing us some pictures later on that Jeannie was able to put together for the format. Let's move to the students who are really the backbone, the center point of all this activity. We're going to meet the students. This is just a sample of a few of many hidden heroes. We'll start with the first with the microphone.
Mike Schaefer. I go to Governor Mifflin High School.
I'm Liz, and I go to Schuylkill Valley High School.
I'm Nikki, and I go to Wilson High School.
I am Rachel, and I go to Wyomissing Junior Senior High.
I am Lexi, and I go to Topahawken.
I'm Dustin, and I go to Hamburg.
I'm Layla, and I'm a former graduate of Wilson High School.
Nice.
I'm Greg, and I go to Governor Mifflin High School.
I'm Trisha, and I go to Wilson High School.
I'm Adrian, and I go to Wilson High School.
Excellent. Welcome all. This is, again, a small sample of the hidden heroes that are really the youth group at the firehouse, which we're going to hear about a little bit through their youth leadership. Let's open up, if we could, with Jeannie and Bill, talking about how this great organization came about and touch upon, with Mark's help, of where this mission trip, as far as Haiti, how far it's traveled, the impact that it's had in the past, and where they need to move now with this tragic devastation of these tremors that they've been feeling down there in Haiti. There's a school bus story we're going to share with you, compliments of Escherman Transportation. We want to send out a special shout of thanks. A lot of hidden heroes in this all-package gift here. Let's start with Jeannie and Bill, if we could. Tell us how this all really came about with your past dealing with the orphanage down in Haiti.
Billy and I have had a little bit of experience with the orphanage with our friend Mark here, who is the president of the organization Team 127. My husband has been to the orphanage and has met some of these children, and he has a heart for these children. Actually, everybody here has a heart for the children that have been devastated by the earthquake in Haiti.
I think it's a great outpouring here in Berks County. We have donation buckets all over town and for Team 127, and this money is going directly to the for rebuilding or to build an orphanage, which Mark can share with us. But I'm just so thankful that we could be here tonight and for these kids and for our youth group and for our church. I want to just give a plug for United Methodist Church and for the openness that we are allowed to be here, and that our church supports us, and the money that's being poured out through the church and through the people of the church and through the West Lawn Wednesdays and f- for people putting money in at the church level at our services, just amazing. Just in a short period of time, and I just thank God for it.
Amen.
Amen.
If you don't realize the magnitude of this powerful church, of one of many in our region here, we're so blessed that the West Lawn United Methodist Church has been around a long time at Penn Avenue and Woodside in West Lawn. They're going to be celebrating their 100th anniversary coming up real soon. They're planning those stages as we speak with the committee. But here's the real big deal here. Every Wednesday, from Labor Day to Memorial Day, most every Wednesday, they have West Lawn Wednesday meals open to the public. It's $6, all you can eat. And I'm telling you, the menu is fabulous. It changes. And most of these people here tonight are volunteering out of that kitchen ministry. It's one of the largest kitchen ministries probably in Berks County, and we're very proud of that. They average between 500 to 600 meals every Wednesday night. On holidays, such as the New Year's Day, it was about 1,200 meals served. But let's move forward, because those monies they raise through the kitchen ministry goes towards mission trips such as this. And Mark is going to be elaborating more particular about where they are in Haiti, where the school that the orphanage children have been staying at. But before we go to that story of the school, there's a school bus story, and I'd like Bill Hendricks and Mark to address that, because they were part of this school bus. It was a bus that Eshelman Transportation out of Plowville, down by Morgantown, was so gracious in putting together and getting a bus ready to be purchased at a very low basic rate of market value for this organization that they're going to be talking to you about, that did go to Haiti, filled, and Brother Bill here has a little story about how filled it truly was. But here's the real neat thing. Because of this tragic, Eshelman's has stepped up to the plate once again, along with many other people in the community, and they're preparing a second bus. Bill, tell us about this school bus.
Which one?
The first and the second one.
We had gotten a school bus. Mark can probably elaborate on that, where it came from. It came from Eshelman's, but we had the church filled it, the community filled it. It just got filled, and it was just amazing. And then Mark made some arrangements, and we drove it to Florida, and I think it was Monarch, wasn't it, Mark, that we shipped it to Haiti. So, but there's another one on the way. So if you didn't get your stuff in the first one, shoes, socks, clothes, food and water, basically beans, and Mark can elaborate on that. We're ready to put another one there within the next few days at the West Lawn United Methodist Church, and there'll be a banner that'll be across there. You'll be able to see where it's at. Bring your stuff there, and we're going to fill it and send it again, so they can, this people can live in it, or they can use it, or they can use all the food that's going to be in it and the clothes. So it's just amazing. I'm just thankful for
that.
That's
fabulous.
Amen.
Mark, bring us up to date where things are currently with the Haiti situation, and where Team 127 is heading.
Okay. Well, I thought many of your listeners might want to know, what is Team 127? What does that mean? And that comes from the Bible in James 1:27, where the Lord says in His Word, what is pure religion and undefiled? It is to care for the orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unspotted from the world. So that's where we got the name of our organization. And it was formed in early 2008 as a way to broker the tremendous resources materially that the United States enjoys, and the tremendous faith that's displayed in Haiti, and to broker the exchange of that freely between the two, because we each have something to offer each other. And my son and I traveled to Haiti in January of 2008, and were adopted by these orphans, which normally it's the other way around. But we were at an orphanage of 63 children that we had supported for years, and it was continuing to grow, and the need is so great there that we thought it would be best if we let other people get in on the blessings. So to document that, and what Daniel Jean, the director of the Divine Ministries and Hope for Children, has been doing in Haiti, we went down there. My son is a professional photographer, artist, and we took footage, which you'll see some of that tonight, on the country of Haiti and the tremendous work and faith of Daniel Jean and his children, who are up by 4:30 every morning from 3 years old and up to pray that God would give them what they need each day. And we in the United States have been taught from when we were very little to pray the Lord's Prayer, as it's called, and in that prayer it says, give us this day our daily bread. We really don't know what that means in the United States, because we have pantries full of food, and if something were to happen to us, or our ability to make some money, we would still be able to eat for many, many days, probably months, on what we already have in our house. That's not true in Haiti. They depend on the Lord daily for fresh bread. They don't have anything for tomorrow, and unless the Lord provides, they go hungry. And we've seen that happen many times. So Team 127 was formed out of compassion for these children, that they would never have to miss another day to have at least one meal. So because of your generosity here of many people in Berks County, that is now true. And the kids are, instead of 63 children, we now have 188 children. We have three locations, two of which were just collapsed in this last earthquake of last Tuesday. But all 188 children survived without a scratch, which we praise God for and just believe that it was His hand on them. Right next door to one of our orphanages where we had 85 girls staying, 86 people were killed. So right next door, and they were inside the building as well. And just praise God that it was 4:53 in the afternoon and not in the middle of the night where everyone would have been sound asleep. And the devastation would have been, the death toll would have been so much greater. So we're just seeing God's hand in everything.
That's wonderful. And we're going to take a look inside more in particular with that DVD as we get queued up to do that. The pictures we have here in the studio that you've seen a little bit of are really from Mark and his son that has really taken some real-time pictures. This is truly, as you see now, a little bit of the Team 127 from the youth group at Westlawn United Methodist Church. But we want to now move to the DVD segment and let you enjoy truly their work of how they're touching their hands upon everybody with the Haiti situation.
Yeah, election time's coming. Who you gonna vote for? Yeah, if I was president, I'd get elected on Friday, assassinated on Saturday, buried on Sunday, they go back to work on Monday. If I was president, if I was president, if I was president, yeah. Instead of spending billions on the war, I can use that money so I can feed the poor. 'Cause I know some so poor. When it rains, that's when they shower, scream and fight the power. That's when the vulture devours. If I was president, I'd get elected on Friday, assassinated on Saturday, buried on Sunday, they go back to work on Monday. If I was president, if I was president.
Welcome to Divine Ministries in Hope for Children. This is the house that we have for those children. We just house them, school them, and the most important thing, we just teach them the Word of God. Our vision is to see those children grow up in the love of Jesus.
Mwen ta reme konen date jou m'ap mouri.
Yeah. Sou te gen 24 ans pou viv. Et puis nou konnen ta pral mouri. 24 ans. Ki sa ta fè? Yo. Si m te gen 24 ans pou viv, mwen ta pral cheke mami, di li te fè yon bon travay avèk premye pitit li. Le yo te rele m volè asasen, li pa janm la gèv, li te toujou pèbe. Bon sou fon tèt li, apre sa pran la ri. Deze et demi, rele Gérald Duplessis-Dil. Vin chache m, depose m, kamadan mwen gade jan abye bien fin. Li zi wikle fan al manje nan tap tap, mwen di mwen pa kap, pase demen mwen pa blab. Mwen selman vin remersi ou a tout kèm pase bagay, mwen te fò pase ou pa mèm te dwe rete avèm. Ou se yon bel fi, ou pa bezwen kriye, depi ou mè malè, ou mè dwe marye.
Mwen ta remè konè, date jou m ap mouri.
you to give it all that you need. That's what I chante, that's what I devrait, that's what I crié. Si yo, rale,
rale,
rale. Si yo, rale,
rale.
You to give it all that you need. That's what I chante, that's what I devrait.
Ça veut ça moi sorti dans canal moi entrer dans machine là pick up cellulaire à col si vrai non
allô parel là marché dans la rue si veillé yo yo gen en pile jalousie même les gueux cap touyer moun pou mou c'est même les gueux cap mettre zam sou parel dit quoi non Samuel c'est lui même qui
mange.
On BCTV, your channel to your community. We're here for the Haiti relief, and we have an exciting group in the house tonight in Studio A. It's from the Westlawn United Methodist Youth Group. They are here on Team 127 to really help raise some funds to help get Haiti back where it should be. We have another team member that just recently joined us. Let's meet our other team member who just came in. He was out delivering some donation buckets. Please introduce yourself if you could, team leader.
My name's Tom Wertz, and I'm the donation coordinator for Team 127. This is just amazing. The youth group that's here, that's been out collecting donations and getting buckets put out, is just fantastic.
That's great. And what we're going to do next is Joe, the other group leader, is going to bring up some DVD pictures to show you a little bit more of an impact so you can really put a face to really what's going on in Haiti. Thanks to the team leadership with Jeannie and Bill, they've got some really good photos we want to bring to you now and show you on your home set here to show you what Team 127 is all about. These are the faces, as you can see, of the true hidden heroes at Westlawn United Methodist Church with the youth group going on. And if you really want to find out more about how this is all, we're going to give you some information on how you can get in touch and contact with Westlawn United Methodist Church and Team 127. We have a graphics that we're going to be showing you after we show you some more of the photos of our great hidden heroes. They were out last Saturday, last week prior to that, raising some great money here in Berks County. And we're going to meet some of those members now and find out what that experience was like for the youth and find out the baseline where the total amount has come in such a short period of time. Jeannie, tell us about the total amount within the last week, how fast it's grown.
Last Saturday we were out at the Lowe's over on Shillington Road and at Auto Spot in Wyomissing, and we raised $2,265.
That's fabulous.
And we repeated Auto Spa again on Monday on the holiday, and we were able to raise another $400. This evening at our Westlawn Wednesday, we raised another $209. So we're close to $3,000 now, and I think by the end of the week, we'll raise $500,000.
That's great. That's the goal. That's for sure.
All right.
Let's meet some of our team members, if we can. Those who have the microphone, we're going to let you pass it around. Tell us about the experience, anybody who would like to chime in at this time, of what it was like on Team 127. They're real easy to notice because you truly can't get the true color of it, but they're really wearing some really great lime green, and I believe the color's changing to add to it as well, to another color shirt next week.
Cyber pink
is coming as well. So when you see these shirts, ask them what it's all about. So some team members, tell us about what it was like collecting all those great funds.
Just when I went out Saturday with Team 127 to the Lowe's, it was just truly amazing. I'd never expected people to donate so much. We had 20s going in, hundreds. It was amazing at how these people were able to donate and give money to this great cause that we're funding.
That's great. Let's move the mic to some other team member. And while we do that, can Bill tell us about the Auto Spa off of State Hill Road? Let's give a thanks to that hidden hero.
My buddy Herb Bressler.
Herb,
the Auto Spa.
We thank you for what you have done in helping us out.
Thank you, Herb, buddy. Thank you. Your business will probably double or triple or quadruple.
Let's talk about the Auto Spa. A team member, can you share with us what was that all about?
All I really did was hold the bucket and say, God bless you and thank you.
That's great.
The experience was pretty moving, or at least for me it was, knowing that you're able to raise money for a country that needs it.
That's fabulous. Another team member. As we move to the other team member, we have graphics one we want to just show real quickly about what the form is all about, how you can obtain these. Here's really what Team 127 is all about, and if Bill and Mark can please chime in and tell us about Westchester, Ohio. There's a reason why it's based out of there.
Yes, when you form a nonprofit organization, which is the basis of Team 127, so that we can give tax-deductible donation receipts to people, you have to form it in one state or another, and our treasurer is my son-in-law, who is very gifted in things that have to do with treasurer-type responsibilities and computer formats, etc. So he did all the groundwork to make Team 127 come into fruition, and so he lives in Westchester, Ohio, and all the donations go there for him to handle and get to the bank expeditiously.
Excellent. Next team member, please. Tell us your thoughts.
Well, I remember that I was the youngest person there, and it didn't really stop me because I knew my older brother was going to be there, and I knew he wasn't too thrilled about me being there. But I wanted to be there to help the people in Haiti because actually my Sunday school teacher had told me that a story that there was a brother who actually dug up his sister and she was alive, but they were the only ones left in their family, and that was just really sad.
That is.
I had to help with, and of course I love being with Jeannie and Billy.
That's great.
So I had
to
help.
Team leaders are awesome. Another team member, please, if you would pass the mic. Here's a number that you want to jot down, if you would. Westlawn United Methodist Church, you can contact their main office in the business office at 610-678-5611. We're going to give you a website, too, where to go to for Westlawn United Methodist Church through the program towards the end. Okay, team member, go right ahead.
I just thought that the experience was awesome. We're helping the kids who really need it, and it was just amazing. On Saturday, we worked so hard at Lowe's and Auto Spa, and it was just so touching to help everybody in Haiti.
That's fabulous, and what a great way to connect to the community and get those volunteer hours for your school requirement as well. See, it all comes together. Another team member who'd like to share their thoughts, just pass the mic down if you would. I believe Tom,
what I'd like to say is these kids work so hard and getting these buckets out. If there's any business out there that would like a bucket, they can call the Westlawn United Methodist Church at 610-678-5611. Ask for extension 14, which will put you in to Jeannie, and Jeannie will get to me or to Bill, and we'll get a bucket out to you. We'll be around once a week to pick up all the donations, so that nothing builds up real high in there. If there's anybody out there, any business that would like us to come out, stand in front of the store with some of these youth and do it out there, we really would appreciate it. We're looking for places to get the youth to do this collection. And this is just one cause that will never, ever, ever stop. This is not going to stop in 4 months. This is not going to be forgotten in 6 months. This is going to go on for years and years and years. So, folks, just hope to hear from you. And this is just an amazing thing. We ran into so many people, Bill and myself, putting these buckets out that it just automatically just hit them and touched our heart so bad that we could see there was tears in some people's eyes and how these people really got fired up to do this, to help this country out, and they're in desperate need.
That's fabulous. Thanks so much, Tom. Again, we want to stress upon you, this is the Westlawn United Methodist Church. This is the youth group. It's Firehouse 209. Bill, tell us about 209.
209 is Jeremiah 20, verse 9, where the word of God is shut up in my bones, and I'm weary to hold it in, I shall not. And that's what we based our Firehouse Youth Ministry on at the Westlawn United Methodist Church. And we love our kids.
Right.
And we love our community.
And it's truly at a firehouse. Tell us
that's
about
right.
what the foundation and the history of that building is.
Well, it's at the old Borough Hall and the old Westlawn Firehouse. And now they have gone together with Spring Township and built a new building, So we're privileged to be in that community center. And then the old firehouse where the guys used to hang out and wait for the bell to ring. Now we're waiting for Jesus to come.
And it's open
the same
to,
room.
Open to any youth member as long as they're under the age of 18 and still in school.
That's right. That's right.
So if you want to get more, we have a home viewer. Let's go to the home viewer at this time. Greetings, home viewer.
Yes, I just want to say quickly, I was a person in South Florida who went through many hurricanes, and I want everybody to imagine that they've been at without electric for a month, they've been without water for 2 weeks, and they've had to walk up to a food truck for their food. This is all of that on steroids, and I want everybody to remember that. I want everybody to give whatever they can to whoever they can and make sure you know who you're giving it to. Thank you.
Amen, brother. Thank you so much for your calls coming in and your comments. Again, let's stress two very important contacts. Jeannie's going to give you an email contact that you can get directly involved with. Jeannie and Bill, who are the youth team, team coaches, the leadership of this organization. And please, you can get in contact with her directly, as Tom has alluded to, the business office phone at West Lawn, of trying to find out how you can become involved, not only through your volunteering, but, of course, your donations. Jeannie, tell us about the information contact.
If you have any questions about Team 127 and our involvement with them, or you have any questions about our Firehouse Youth Ministry, you can contact me at fire_house@westlawnumc.org.
Fabulous. And we want to invite you all out next Wednesday. Come out to West Lawn Wednesday evenings for the meals. They start around 4:30. And meet these great team leaders and the hidden heroes of the youth ministry here at West Lawn United Methodist Church. It is a cause that they have set the bar to $1 million that they are going to raise, and in time they will make that obligation come true. I'm Tom Frank for the Victory Program, wishing you all a great Victory Day and thanking you for staying tuned in and helping out with the Haiti Relief through West Lawn United Methodist Church Youth Group.
Victory is supported by Skyline Drive Corvette Club and Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.